two banks are taking the worst in terms of losses. SBI and ICICI are in the green. Okay, so markets just about flat at this point in time. It's a great time to get longer term advice. The only guys with money still flowing in the market are the domestic institutions, the mutual funds. So that's the United States Marines, as I call them. And Manish Gunwani, the finest, the captain of one such a ship, is with us today in the studio. Well, U.S. Marines, I am putting the live boats. I am going now.
Yeah, I mean, whenever markets correct, obviously the valuations become better. So we are definitely seeing some value emerging right now. Very broad-based. And then if you look at steady return industries like IT, regulated utilities, I think there is value around there. From the medium
MCC types, steady regulated utilities.
From a medium term perspective, I think a lot of domestic companies between banks, captive roads, cement, and they are also starting to look very attractive.
Okay. Well, Lisa, I've been wondering, yes, as someone yesterday at the Morgan Stanley conference was telling us, it's like a super sale in the market now, and this is just the kind of correction that a lot of retail investors who missed the bus, they were looking out for. But be that as it may, in the coming months, do you think that this market has the potential to correct some more? And if yes, how much more downside would you forecast?
It's very difficult to time markets, but let me kind of put it in a framework. I think is the business cycle uptrend denied? I don't think so. The macro is good, the environmental scheme and the
macro.
So let me come to that. So long-term macro is good. I think the velocity of the business uptrend is in question because partially it depends on the stimulus. And if you look at stimulus, there are only three ways of stimulus can be provided to an economy. One is monetary, one is fiscal, and one is currency. Unfortunately, I think all three are tied today at the same time. And maybe that is what is holding us back. But again, these are tied, which means that over the long term, structurally inflation will be low. So maybe setting the base for a very long program in the Indian economy. And to that extent, it's a positive. But along with that comes the fact that in the short run, you probably are not going to see the velocity of the uptrend which we were all probably hoping for 1 year back.
Okay, fair point. This is not a time to look just at stock prices, but look at the long term macro. And I'm with you on it. Things are definitely in the mend and perhaps already mended. Nevertheless, you know, how much can a correction come? Do you think that, fundamentally, we also are going to think like you. Would they come at 15 times, 15 and a half times? After we did see even the huge tsunami of paper top selling, that at 5,200, everyone thought it was a buy, and then the ferocity of the upturn was also rather rapid. So do you think it is that valuation number we should look at? And if that is so, is it worth 15 and a half, 15 times, 16 times?
What's the very composite valuations matter, and we're not very far off from the mean, probably 16 times, mean is 15 times. But again, it's a mix of very different kind of companies. So a commodity company are probably at single-digit PEs. Some of the high-quality names we think are still overpriced because if you see a historical price earning or price to book basis, a lot of these companies still are not very cheap. So I think you probably have to look at what stocks you want to buy rather than, let's say, a Nifty PE or some fixed PE.
So that's more for a long term. Somebody, an expert just an hour ago was telling us that they're probably in the last 5% of the fall. That is fairly decent guess.
Well, it's put in this way that we don't expect a big number from her.
Okay.
I'd be very, very surprised if that happens because, as we were discussing, I mean, if the countries we are probably still having a lot of room to cut rates over the medium term. You have growth which is at cyclical lows. Typically, market tops are not formed with that macro. Mm-hmm. We generally believe that market tops are when IIP is 10%, credit growth is 25%. Right,
I will not. Okay. I'm going to also go for our blue chip fund. This is as of December 2014, so it's slightly dated. But you still have a lot of private sector banks in your portfolio. So whether it's ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, HDFC, and a stock like ICICI Bank is down 20% from its peak. So is this a good time to be locking up some of these good quality private sector banks?
So definitely, from a long-term perspective, we've always maintained that private banks are in a very good space because you have very large industry. The industry grows faster than nominal GDP most of the years. Market share is still 25-30% versus the PSU sector, which has its own issues in terms of service levels, efficiency, etc. Banks will be subject to the business cycle velocity, not only the direction but also the velocity of the business cycle. So if your velocity is lower, then the deleveraging process is slower, in which case your asset quality improvement, which we probably were thinking would happen faster 6 months or 1 year back, that will obviously got affected to a certain extent. Mm-hmm. You can also see a tighter of some of the over leveraged corporates. It seems to indicate that the deleveraging process of the economy is slower than probably what was expected. Mm-hmm. But I think it's a matter of time, frankly.
So there were a couple of bankers telling me yesterday that even in the previous cycle, it was as if the bad loans fell in a very big
way.
The amount of good loans rose so rapidly that the percentage of bad loans as a percentage of the total book declines, and
treasury book profits. That gives you a good buffer as well.
Unfortunately, the 75 basis point rate cut has come at a time when there has been a global surge in yields, which has negated what we may have had in terms of an advantage in the yield book, and that's the question I'm coming to now. The surge in yields is obviously presaging an expectation of a Fed rate hike. Do you think that first hike we will see the calm after the storm? Because the Fed has indicated in several ways that it will hike, but thereafter it's not in step for the series of hikes. So do you think, just as the S&P downgrade, first downgrade brought a long period of funds rushing into buy assets, do you think that is an event which might declutter?
My sense is also that probably not going to be very disruptive, and my thought process is probably that the world growth is strong. You would see it in different places, especially commodity prices, right? So you're not getting any sign that the developed countries are going to go back to the 2003-07 kind of phase.
Okay.
Where all the regions were firing simultaneously.
I just want to point out that the finance minister and the minister of state finance, I think that's what Adi has done, the financial services secretary are preparing for the bankers' meet. I just want to add that this time the private sector bankers have also been invited, and our reporters phoned in that Shikha Sharma and Aditya Puri and Mr. Kalyan from ICICI. Were also noted in the vicinity of the meeting. It's a larger public sector bank gathering as well. My sense is that there's going to be a strong pitch from the public sector banks for more capital. That's already gone a letter from the Reserve Bank. So that is, of course, one part of the conversation. And the other thing, of course, we already noticed a lot of base rate cuts in the run up to this meeting. So that when he calls and says, why have you not transmitted everyone? Say, either 15 basis, either 30 basis, or whatever. But nobody is obviously giving 75. Puri Secretary mentioned in that interview to us that he expects over the next 1 year, maybe a 75 basis, 1 percentage point rate cut. Now, that's why the your expectation. You think money will get that cheaper in the next 12 months?
I think directionally it's pretty clear that rates have to come down in this economy. I don't see too much sign of inflation, whether it be manufacturing or food, say a monsoon, which is kind of extremist thing. But it's difficult to emphasize that if globally deflation is a problem, and we have a fairly progressive government which is focused on managing inflation. It's not a forecast that you would get inflation level surprise on the upside.
Okay. Coming back to the, to what one should be buying now, you mentioned that private sector banks are a good place to be. The other pocket that you have a relatively high exposure in is software. So 15% of your total holdings is in software, names like Infosys, Tech Mahindra, etc. But the last quarter was not a great one for them. What kind of returns would you expect from some of these top tier technology names?
So we think it's one of the very steady state kind of sector. Obviously, if a sector is $1,800 million, you can't expect it to grow like 20%. They want to grow at a very mature pace. Part of the reason we are also attracted to a sector is that we think in this world, the dollar is tending to be very strong. And the fact that currency depreciation is probably one of the stimulus we need to move the sector along. Probably unlike the 2003-07 cycle, we're not going to have a very strong appreciation in the currency.
Okay.
So to that extent, when we look at the valuations today, which related to the market are quite attractive, given the fact that these are very high ROE cash flow generating companies, with a very strong management team.
Okay.
We're kind of attracted to that sector right now.
Okay. Well, I have a couple of very quick questions. So, when would you say that the slight anti-India phase is over? Rather, the selling would be over. Would it be when global yields start stabilizing and softening? Would that be what you would look at? Or would you look at a higher number? But more importantly, until now, you guys, the BIs, domestic institutions, have been countering the FII sale. Can you expect that trend to continue? Do you see yourself hydrated?
Taking the second point first, I think one of the strongest points for this market is domestic savings moving into equity. Maybe there's a blip here or there, but I think it's a bit more structural in the sense that if you look at real estate and loan, etc., we still think that the shift from that to equities is a multi-year theme. So we do see domestic investors move into bonds and equities from multi-year perspective, I think. So that part, I think, is not a debate. Coming to the question of foreigners, that's not a different debate because obviously it's subject to global risk off. But again, there probably, if the currency was a bit more competitive, foreigners would be more attracted. So maybe that is a kind of small trigger that can happen.
I was waiting for it, actually. Manish Gunwani, it was a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you very much for joining us on what's a crucial day for the markets. And you probably are the lucky talisman. Today the markets have not fallen. There is slackness and the sensitive Nikkei are also sitting in and out of the green. And the caps at this point in time are actually in the green.